Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron, I hope you're having a great day in Jesus. Now, there's a phrase out there that's kind of become popular in American Christianity, and it's God only looks on the heart. And they get that from 1 Samuel 16:7. I'll give you a little bit of the context. You can read it for yourself, that Samuel has been told one of the sons of Jesse is going to be king instead of Saul. He goes to anoint. And so, you know, Samuel looks at Eliab and says, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. And because, you know, Saul, he was head and shoulders above everybody and all that. And so God begins to speak to Samuel and says this, but the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, that's how good he looks, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. Now, we do know the heart is the most important thing. Jesus, when he's ripping the Pharisees in Matthew 23, he says, make first clean the inside of the cup and platter. But then he says that the outside may be clean as well. First Thessalonians 5 says that God came to sanctify our body, soul, and spirit blameless to him. 1 Corinthians 6, it talks about he came to make us holy in body and spirit, make our body and spirit holy. And so God created the outside as well as the inside. And look at even the immediate context here. Don't look on his countenance, whether he's cheerful, you know, whether he's naturally good looking or the height of his stature. It doesn't mean that you can do anything possible in your outward person, and it's totally fine with God. I mean, in the Old Testament, there were ways. In the Old Testament, there were certain clothing strictures. And even in the New Testament, 1 Timothy 2, you know, women need to dress in certain ways, have modest apparel, the Bible says. 1 Peter 3 talks about, you know, don't adorn yourself with gold and silver and costly array, but as a woman that professes godliness, you know, with good works. And, you know, 1 Timothy 2, 1 Peter chapter 3. Immodesty is something that's condemned scripturally. Deuteronomy 22:5 talks about certain clothing things. And so Jesus, yes, we've got to have a pure heart, but at the same time, we have to realize we live in this flesh and that we can make people fall through our flesh. So, well, they shouldn't be looking. Well, God created people, especially men, to look. There's a difference between men and women in that. That is just scientifically verifiable. And, you know, they've just done different scientific studies. And so, yes, there is a difference. So God doesn't see as man sees, because we can only see the outside of a person, but God does look on the heart. But God does look on the inside as well. It doesn't say that God only looks on the heart, you know, but he does see the heart. So we don't need to use certain scriptures taken vastly out of context and in negation of another vast amount of New Testament literature to justify our own actions. If you want to be scriptural, but don't have one foot in the world and one foot with God and say, I can do what I want, I can look how I want, I can dress how I want, because we're not supposed to have self-will, we're supposed to have God's will. And that extends to how even we are dressed. And again, I've done other videos. You can look up 1 Timothy 2, 9 and 10. That is not cultural. That is something that is applicable to all Christians at all time. Same with 1 Peter chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Not cultural. Not something just for Corinth, because he talks about, does not even nature itself teach you this? The creation teaches you this, and from the beginning. So all of those things. So God does look on the heart, but he doesn't look only on the heart. And our heart should give us, we should want to please God in everything. If a man looks upon a woman to lust, he's committed adultery in his heart already. So a woman shouldn't dress in ways to cause a man to fall. Now, if women, they're not saved, they do dress in ways like that, men, it doesn't justify you for looking. You need to have your flesh crucified enough to where you're not looking. All right. So we want to love everybody. Different people have different struggles. And there are different areas in their life. So, you know, we're not into what do they call slut shaming and all that. We don't do that. We love everybody. So, well, God bless. I just want to talk to you about that a little bit. And we'll talk with you later. In Jesus' name, amen.